Welcome to Analytics with Nags. Welcome to SQL Server Integration Service introduction video. And this is about knowing what is SSIS and in what scenarios or what is the purpose we need to use this particular tool. Let us explore it in this video. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for the notification. So it is SQL Server Integration Service or SSIS. Both are commonly used across the industry, and it is basically a ETL tool. So ETL stands for extract, transform, and load. So we have different data sources. You need to extract it and you need to do certain transformation before loading it. That is what the purpose of this tool. So when it will be used, or most of the organizations use this tool when they have a data warehousing in place. So if an organization having data warehouse, they need to have ETL tool. It may not be a SSIS, it can be any other ETL tool like Informatica or Teradata. There are a lot of other ETL tools available in the market, but this is one of the ETL tool, and it is used to implement widely for data warehousing projects. You also, it's used for data migration projects as well, like the existing applications. The backend will be Oracle, and the new age applications, they want to build it, whose database can be in the SQL server. So they want to move this data from one database to another, or from different one server to another service as well. So these kind of data migration projects also people will use SSIS. And finally, last but not least, like database maintenance activities, like sometimes we need to rebuild the indexes and clean up some of the temporary tables, and also in the folder level you need to do certain kind of cleaning process. So those kind of automation can also be achieved using SSIS. So let us talk about the BI architecture, and we'll try to understand where this SSIS plays the role, right? So this is the sources, different OLTP sources, and the data preparation, whatever you are seeing here, the second layer is called your data warehousing layer, where you have two different phases. One is staging and your data warehouse. There will be some other databases like DQS and MDS. Most of the companies using it. Some of them are not using it. It depends. That is fine. But what the role of SSIS here? As I said before, whenever you have a data warehousing projects, you will use some ETL tools. Here it is, SSIS solves that purpose. Like, you need to take this data and store it here. That is moving here data. It's not a moving, it can be a copying. I should not say moving. Moving means we will delete and load it here. It's not moving. You want to copy the data from one place to another place, right? Then you will use this tool, right? That is the main purpose. So once you load it here, and you will build your fact and dimensions in data warehouse. For that population also, you will use SSIS, and DQS to MDS also, you will need to move here staging or either data warehouse. It depends upon the architecture. So everywhere, whenever there is a data movement, you will use it. Even here, it will be used like SSIS processing task, but it is very small part of SSIS, like 5% of it. Once you deploy it in SSIS, then you will do regular processing. Those kind of steps you can use it. So as I said before, it will be used for data migration, but the 80% of the organization use SSIS for data warehousing projects. That is why I'm trying to explain the BI architecture or data warehouse architecture with respect to SSIS. So what you can expect in this course is like, Predominantly, like you will have SSIS fundamentals, like topics of SSIS fundamentals, and then how to implement the data warehousing using SSIS. That is what I'm going to cover in this entire SSIS course, right? So the fundamentals topics, you can see control flow, data flows, transformations, control flow task. Then here you will have a very high level overview. Then we will jump deep into control flow task, precedence constraints, what is containers, looping. So this covers entire basics of SSIS, how you need to work on a SSIS project. Then there comes implementation part, like when you have a data warehouse, the ultimate aim is to build star schema, dimension, fact and dimensions. So how you use SSIS to populate this fact and dimensions, and you were fine with it, right? Once you populate data warehouse, then in the event handlers, like when something is failed, you need to automate some emails. Those kind of real-time scenarios I'm going to cover. Then finally, you have where these processes are. Once you build, it should be stored somewhere. So this is the place where it can be stored, and you can deploy it. Then you will schedule an automation. So this is what the entire course is going to be. Let's try to explore it in our upcoming videos. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for your queries. Do remember that data is your asset.